Welcome to my channel, detailing events throughout history. 1937, the Hindenburg Airship Crash. The Hindenburg departed from Frankfurt on the evening of May 3, 1937. This was the first of 10 round trips between Europe and the United States. American Airlines had contracted the Hindenburg to shuttle passengers from Lakehurst to Newark for their connecting air flights. The Hindenburg was the largest airship ever built. It was over 800 feet long from nose to tail. The crossing of the Hindenburg was uneventful, even though there were strong headwinds which slowed the journey. The airship attempted an early evening landing at Lakehurst, 3 days later on May 6. The Hindenburg was only carrying half of its capacity of passengers at the time, but was fully booked for the return journey, due to passengers wanting to attend the coronation of King George VI and Queen Elizabeth in London, England. Due to the headwinds, the Hindenburg was several hours behind schedule. The landing at Lakehurst was also expected to cause delay due to afternoon thunderstorms. Captain Pruss took passengers on the Hindenburg on a tour over New Jersey while waiting for weather conditions to improve. At 6:22 in the evening, Captain Pruss was informed that the thunderstorm had passed, and he made his way back to Lakehurst. He was now almost half a day late. At 7 in the evening, at 650 feet, the Hindenburg made its final approach to Lakehurst Naval Air Station. It was going to be a high landing and the airship would drop its landing ropes and mooring cable at a high altitude, it would then be winched down to its mooring mast. The Hindenburg had only done this maneuver a few times before in 1936. The ground crew were not ready, so at 7:09 the Hindenburg made a full-speed left turn around the landing field. At 7:17 the wind shifted direction, and Captain Pruss had to do a second sharp starboard turn, while on the way towards the mooring mast. At 7:21, some witnesses saw the fabric of the upper fin flutter as though gas was leaking from it. Other witnesses reported that they saw a dim blue flame just moments before the fire. At 7:25, the Hindenburg erupted in fire and was quickly engulfed. The rear of the airship soon imploded. Buoyancy was lost on the stern of the airship, and the bow lurched upwards. The ship's back broke and the tail of the Hindenburg crashed to the ground. Flames shot out of the nose of the airship, killing 9 crew members. The gondola also came crashing to the ground. Most of the fabric on the hull was gone, and the bow crashed to the ground. Diesel fuel burned for several hours after the crash. 97 people were on board at the time. 36 passengers and 61 crew members. 35 people died that day, 13 passengers and 22 crew. One worker on the ground was also killed. The final death toll was 36. The Bourdon inquiry was set up at Lakehurst to investigate the crash. At the time it was suggested by the Zeppelin company that the crash was due to sabotage. Threatening letters had been received before the crash. Captain Pruss himself even believed this. It was also suggested that Adolf Hitler had ordered the Hindenburg to be destroyed. Another theory was that the fire was started by an electric spark due to the buildup of static electricity on the airship, which ignited hydrogen on the outer skin. It was reported that gasoline was smelt by people on board. Others suggested that Captain Pruss's final turns were too sharp and caused a support wire to snap inside the ship, tearing open one of the hydrogen gas cells. Many of the crew members and passengers did, however, survive, despite the ferocity of the fire, but most of them had suffered severe burns. The site of the crash is marked by a chain-outlined pad and bronze plaque where the ship's gondola landed. It was dedicated on May 6, 1987. On the 50th anniversary of the crash. Thank you for watching and learning about events throughout the decades. Forever remembering those who perished on that fateful day. May we never forget.